wanted to say thank you to the city marshals and Mark Barber and his group. As usual, we battled the cars and in my neighborhood and the yards and things like that. And working really hard to help correct that and educate and find where necessary. It's making a difference. Drive through the district and you'll see where people are using. They are parking in certain areas, but it's designated with the proper wood timbers and stuff like that they put out. So they're doing a good job. We still have a problem. We usually do at the start of every school year with that new group of freshmen come in and then putting 10 to 12 people living in a house and that many cars just don't work in the front yard. So I appreciate what the marshals are doing. And Matt, I appreciate your comments about the district and we've worked very hard to keep our district businesses where they should be and not in our neighborhoods. If you could convince some of the others up here to vote with me more often on that, we wouldn't have a footprint clinic on the corner in a neighborhood that where it should be. That was a home, that was a neighborhood that now has been destroyed.
That's why I'm running.
But I do appreciate that. We're working hard to keep those types of businesses where they need to be, which is in a business district. And I appreciate the council and their votes and working with me on those efforts to keep our neighborhoods the way they should be. Now, those neighborhoods that have five or six liquor stores, Mr. Hampton, I'm sorry, but my duty is to protect a neighborhood to keep them from coming in and not be somewhere, something like another district where they have five or six in the district. In neighborhoods, on your corners across the street from houses, it shouldn't happen. We shouldn't be fighting about liquor stores in a neighborhood. And there are other things that we work very hard to keep out. But as long as I'm up here, I will continue to do that, so just get used to it. It'll be the same song and dance. I just hope that the vote will be a little different next time. But I'm proud of the council and the employees of the city and what we've accomplished lately and what Mr. Hansen has told us tonight about some of the work that's going on. But I am also proud of our school system and go Cats.
Mr. Mayor, let me just make one final comment as about the Curtis Mincy, the award. You know, about 10 years ago, I walked into this building and he was doing all that work here and all of this work in the city around these runs. I don't know a person who is more deserving than him to get that reward. And I wanted to thank him personally. I think he's there.
We arranged it for you.
Councilman Hampton, that was a little more than 7 or 8 or 10 years ago.
I know.
Monday or Tuesday morning, when we walk back, we'll take the walk to school. So
So, and to the citizens, same guy, a number of citizens. The city of Valdosta, we are very fortunate to have the caliber of city employees and their expertise in different areas of the city. We are very fortunate to have someone who has risen up the ladder, from the bottom of the ladder up to the top of the ladder as our city manager. And I've seen the growth in the city manager in the last 25 years.
Six or seven.
We have been fortunate in this community for the last 30 years to just have two cities, just to have two city managers in 30 years. That's really, really had broken the record. The time for a city manager to stay somewhere, it is probably 3 to 5 years. Larry and his staff has climbed the ladder and educated themselves and the department in different fields, different expertise, you know. And this is what it takes in order for a community to grow and keep some stability. This community for the last 30 years, along, I can just go back and forth, that I can remember and I can understand and I can come to appreciate our staff. And also come to appreciate council members. In the last 30 years, the council has ability. The council has always had from 5 to 6 council members that we maintain. We never swept the room, you know. And experience count. And now you can't show me another city when you measure apples to apples. Where the only thing that we left only 4 years, looked at 4.something. When I 4.1, when I came on city council in 1985, it was 3 meals. 3 meals. It has risen 1 meal. In the last 25 or so years, 1 meal, because now we've had growth and we had others, and we have a $7 to $8 million budget, and just about $5.5 million come from property tax, and the rest of it come from other sources through fees and grants and you know.
Fees and charges, usually.
User fees, you know. That's saying something. Then it's saying something to the citizen. Well, in 1985, when I come to council, we had 26 miles of dirt streets. We had rioting police cars and run down fire trucks, and we had bad water. And when you go and look back at all of those things that we have taken care of all of the things, do we still have some issues here? We still have some issues, and our belt had to be tightened in the last 3 years. We did, I don't think we did no layoffs. We did some early retirement. We use our rainy day fund, but that's what rainy day fund is, the plan when the sun is shining. And so when rain comes, we can kind of manage without raising the property taxes. And we work very diligent and very mindful of maintaining and looking out for the tax dollars. I can hardly get a penny out of the city, man. No more for nothing. If they need the budget, you can't get it. You know, you say, man, I'm sorry, it just ain't enough, you know. And also, council members has went off to training and development. The things that we learned in 1987, we brought it back here for you from Christmas, Texas, about retreats. Well, you know, we come back and we used to get about going on retreat, buddy. denying Bill Rainwater, and we said, okay, son, we gonna do it. And we came with the 1% sales tax in 1988, and we started planning, having a measure stick that we could measure what was going on. And that's what got us where we are today. So I don't want council members, and I don't want staff, and I don't want the senators to get about how we got where we at today. Yeah, we have little problems here and there, but you need to check the record and see what happened.